Hi everyone, welcome to my English class. I am G. Arna, working as PGT English in Telangana State Model School, Mutsyal, Mandal Cherial. Today, I am going to explain a lesson from our 10th class textbook, Unit 8, Reading C. The lesson name is What is My Name? Written by P. Satyavati. About the author. Srimati P. Satyavati is one of those writers who have brought feminism to the peak in Telugu literature. Though she is a retired English lecturer, she has great understanding of the Telugu accent and the idiom of the respective regions. She is adept in portraying human experience universally. The technique of appealing to the readers by weaving the story wonderfully with a philosophical touch and theological aspect in her forte. She has published 4 anthologies of short stories, 5 novels and a collection of essays. She has won a number of prestigious awards. This story, What is My Name, is originally published as Illalkagane Pandugavna in Telugu in 1990 and has been translated into almost all South Indian languages and Hindi. So we'll go through glossary. Swap, clean, dexterous, skillful, sumptuous, luxurious, splendid. Mopping, cleaning, washing, perturb, bother, disturb, trouble. Daubing, the act of spreading a substance such as mud thickly. Immerse, observe oneself in something. Giggling, laughing nervously. Frantically, worriedly, anxiously. Maternity home, hospital for deliveries. Purge, dehydrate, incognito, having a concealed identity. Fish, search. We'll go through the summary of What is My Name. So here the title itself indicates it is about identity. Here P. Satyavati wanted to stress more on identity of married women. So we will go through the summary now. P. Satyavati's creative piece, What is My Name, is a moving story. It describes a young woman's urge for identity. It pictures the predication a housewife finds herself in. It sounds incredible, yet it presents women's plight realistically. Satyavati's Telugu narration is rendered into English by Vadrevu Vijayalakshmi and Rangarao. She is a beautiful young girl till marriage, an intelligent, witty and artistic girl as she is before marriage. She becomes a mere housewife immersed in swabbing floor and designing colorful mugulu after marriage. She is so absorbed and confined to her household chores that she forgets her own name one fine morning. She worried a lot. She tries hard but fails to remember her own name. One's name is not just a name. It is a symbol of one's identity. It stands for one's individuality. Now she has lost it. She asks her maid for her name besides asking her children, her neighbor, her husband, her mother and father. But everyone replies in a different way. For the servant, she is Ammagaru. For children, Amma. For neighbors, just a tall, fair woman. For husband, Emoi. And for parents, Ammai. Adding insult to the injury, everyone questions the need to have a name. She is pained. As her eager search for her name continues, her classmate calls her Sharada. Now Sharada recollects her school days, her first rank, her photos, her pictures, albums, prizes, etc. Now she is determined to live as Sharada. She proudly shows her childhood drawings to her children. Swabbing is no longer her life. It is only a small part of her life, she declares to her husband. Individuality at last dawns on her. May every woman regain her own identity along with Sharada. So here Satyavati wanted to stress more on identity of a married woman. So this identity comes to a woman by woman empowerment, nothing but education. So if education only brings her own identity to a woman. So I hope everyone understood. Thank you for watching my video.